quite visually, but we can detect that with the satellites.
Juliet keeps a particularly close eye on a little-known volcanic system in East Africa.
It's right next to the rapidly growing town of Hawassa. We think there's about 1.5 million people living within 100 kilometres of this volcano. And we also know that it's been uplifting at a rate of about 6 centimetres every year for the past 10 years.
Currently, there's no cause for concern, but things can change quickly with any potentially erupted volcano.
That's my son, Larry.
We're monitoring things and we start to see unprecedented levels of activity, unprecedented numbers of earthquakes, unprecedented amounts of deformation. That might tell us that something unprecedented is about to happen.
For volcanologists, the ultimate goal is to be able to predict when and where a major eruption could take place. For a super volcano,
he looks a lot like my sister-in-law.
Tens of thousands of lives and mobilize rescue operations more rapidly.
The final frontier really is forecasting what that means for future eruptions and for the people living around the volcanoes.
For now, eruption remains an inexact science. Nobody knows for sure whether a super eruption is 10 years away or 10,000. But scientists on the ground at Yellowstone are reacting to whatever Mother Nature throws their way. They must keep a watchful eye on this ticking time bomb. Mike Poland is the park's chief scientist, responsible for monitoring activity.
We have many different tools we can use to monitor activity.
There
are dozens of seismometers scattered all throughout the park that measure subtle vibrations of the ground. We've got many tens of GPS stations that measure how the ground moves up and down all over the Yellowstone region. We sample gases.
Only thing is,
today, Mike's using an ingenious new piece of technology, a gravity monitor.
Depending on how much gravity might pull a little harder or a little less hard, and we can measure that. And by looking for changes in gravity over time, we might be able to see whether there's more magma beneath our feet.
It's a new approach for Yellowstone, but one with proven results.
Gravity's shown a lot of promise worldwide for helping forecast volcanic activity. For example, at Kilauea, as magma accumulates beneath the surface, we've seen increases in gravity. We're hoping that we might be able to apply the technique here in Yellowstone as well.
These different monitoring techniques help Mike and his team develop a clear understanding of the region's unique character.
The kind of background activity we see at Yellowstone might be alarming at another volcano, but it's normal here at Yellowstone. And by understanding at background level, we can learn to recognize when things truly get anomalous.
Only by measuring Yellowstone's baseline activity can they identify changes that might indicate an imminent eruption.
We can kind of characterize the way Yellowstone should be acting when it's quiet. And when Yellowstone is quiet, it turns out it's really noisy. There's all kinds of earthquakes. The ground moving up and down. Geysers stopping and starting. That's how Yellowstone behaves.
And it's not just ground-based monitoring. Mike also relies on even more high-tech methods. Thanks to radar satellite imaging, Mike discovered a previously unknown feature.
We've actually managed to detect new thermal areas using satellites that we didn't even know existed. Way in the backcountry, places where people just don't visit, because we've seen one get hotter, trees died around it, and started seeing even small amounts of sulfur gas being emitted.
But changes like this might not indicate an eruption anytime soon. Scientists are only beginning to understand just how energetic Yellowstone really is.
It's incredibly dynamic. It's always changing. And the fact that we can see these changes, both on the ground and from space, is incredibly exciting.
Yellowstone is one of the most closely watched volcanic sites in the world, but no amount of monitoring can actually stop an eruption. It may not happen until far into the future, but when a super eruption is unleashed, it will be truly spectacular.
It would appear that Yellowstone is broadly due for an eruption, but that might not be for plus or minus 10,000 years, and it's inevitable it will happen.
So how might such a disaster unfold?
At
there were an eruption that were about to happen, magma rising towards the surface, we would see incredible uplift. The ground inflated by fire.
He was the guy on Sons of Anarchy. He looks like the guy that was on 50 Shades of Grey.
Known as potentially a volcanic winter, where temperatures drop by 10, 15 degrees or more, which is enough to really utterly change human life as we know it.
But this wouldn't be the first time human beings have faced such a task.
We as a species, our common ancestors, were walking on the planet during massive supervolcanic eruptions that devastated the environment, and we have survived, and we went on to thrive.
The human species may survive, but will America survive this volcanic doomsday? A Cold War era robotic flyship. What this is a miniature unmanned aerial vehicle. Reveals the roots of a black budget-funded robotic revolution.
The robot actually thinks, understands the world. These systems are always learning, they're always developing.
Now, Blackfall Funds are engineering completely autonomous robots.
It would decide whether an attack was underway, look to see if there was anybody to give it orders, and if not, broadcast launch orders to all nuclear weapons and destroy everything.
Bringing us to the brink of robotic warfare.
The locust swarm just starts attacking the target on the ground by itself, making its own decisions and adapting to the conditions on the battlefield.
Exactly.
Larry, let Moon out.
Classified documents reveal it was a semi-autonomous robotic spy called the Inspector. It was developed by engineers at the CIA and the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, or DARPA, as part of a clandestine program in 1976. Today, that $70,000 black funnel has morphed into more than $7 billion for Defense Department robotics.
One thing I noticed in the background of one of these photos. Doesn't show it very well. Dang it. But I know him. Yes, Moon.